Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation lecture on equilibrium. Learning objectives, what we are going to discuss today in this lecture. See, we are going to discuss the structure of receptor organ which are responsible for our equilibrium. Equilibrium means the balancing of our body. So, which are the cells that are present in the receptor organ, where actually the receptor organs are present, and how the nerve signals are generated, and how the nerve signal, they finally reach to the brain center, and we balance our body. So, all this thing we are going to discuss in this lecture. So, now we are starting with the first point. See, both the ear of our body, left and right, they are not only responsible for detecting the sound only, but they are also involved in the equilibrium of the body. Equilibrium meaning our ear are also involved in the balancing of our body. Now, our body movement stimulate the receptors. And receptors are involved in the equilibrium process. For example, our body movement, like the linear acceleration or deceleration. So, due to the linear acceleration or deceleration of our bodily movement, the receptors are stimulated, they become activated. Now, what is linear acceleration and deceleration? See, imagine you are sitting in your car and you give a key, you start your car. Okay, so now suddenly your car jerks, okay, and after the jerking, now you are speeding up your car. That means initially the speed was zero, now you are progressively you are increasing the speed of your car. So the speed rises up from zero, then 10 kilometer, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. So you are speeding up the car. That time your body is in a linear acceleration, and when you are close to your destination, that time you are going to decrease the speed of your car. So that time your body is in a deceleration. So now in acceleration or deceleration, the receptors are stimulated. Okay, so this is the one way that this receptors of our equilibrium are stimulated. Now the second way the receptors are stimulated, see, when you are tilting your head forward or backward. For example, when you are saying yes, okay, that time also, for example, here this man, the head of this man is in an upright position, and here when we say yes, so here you can see the head is tilted forward. So when the head is tilted forward, that time also the receptor for the equilibrium are stimulated. Okay, then the rotational acceleration or deceleration. Now, what is a rotational or angular acceleration or deceleration? So, for example, when you are having a ride in a roller coaster, that time immediately you are taking a quick curve. So that type of movement of the body also stimulate the receptor organs of our equilibrium. Okay, so all this type of movement, as linear acceleration, deceleration, or the tilting of head, or the rotational acceleration, deceleration, all this type of movement activate or stimulate our receptor organ, which are present in our ear and are involved in the equilibrium of the body. Okay, so this is the second point of our discussion. Now we are discussing the third point. Now, collectively, receptor organ for equilibrium are known as vestibular apparatus. Okay, what is vestibular apparatus? Vestibular apparatus are receptor organ. Vestibular apparatus is actually a receptor organ, and they are involved in the equilibrium of our body. Now, in this vestibular apparatus, what is included? So, utricle is included in vestibular apparatus. Sacule is involved in vestibular apparatus. Then, the semicircular duct of semicircular canal, they are also the part of the vestibular apparatus. So, simply we can say vestibular apparatus means utricle plus sacule plus semicircular duct. Okay, so here in this figure you see over here vestibule. So utricle, sacule are part of vestibule. Okay, and here see with the arrow utricle, this is the utricle, and this one is the sacule they are showing. So vestibule plus these are the 1, 2, and 3, these three semicircular duct. Okay, so all this collectively they form the vestibular apparatus. Okay, so in the vestibular apparatus, receptor organ for equilibrium are present. Now let me show you this figure. Okay, let's see. Now the fourth point we are discussing: otolytic organ, utricle and sacule. Now there are two otolytic organ. One is utricle, second one is sacule. Okay, so in the figure we have seen this utricle and sacule, they are the otolytic organs. Now this utricle and sacule, in them what happen? See, the inner walls of both utricle and sacule, with that attach a small thick region. So once again, on the inner wall of utricle and sacule, small thick region is attached, which is known as macula. So simply we can say, in the inner wall of utricle and sacule, macula is attached, and macula is small and thick region. So in the figure here you can see, this is the utricle, and inside you can see utricular macula they are showing. Okay, this dark purple region is utricular macula, and here the sacule they are showing, and inside the dark purple color region, sacula macula. So this is the fourth point: utricle and sacule are two otolytic organ, and in this organs inside macula is present. Okay, macula, small thick region. Now we are discussing the fifth point. Now two macula, plural macule, okay, two macula contain receptor. So what is macula? Macula are having receptor, okay, and these receptors are for linear acceleration and deceleration, and the receptors are also responsible for position of the head. Okay, so simply we can say during the linear acceleration or deceleration, or the movement of the or the position of the head activates the receptor which are present in the macula. Okay, now in the macula, two types of cells are present. One type of cell are the hair cell. They act as a sensory receptor, and the another type of cell are the supporting cell. So here in the figure, as you can see this blue color portion, utricle and saccule are shown. So location of utricle and saccule contain maculae, and here the maculae receptor organ they are showing. So in this receptor organ of maculae, you can see these are the hair cell. So with the blue color, the hair cells are shown, and adjacent to this hair cell, this are the supporting cell. Okay, so in the structure of macula, in the structure of receptor organ of the macula, hair cell and the supporting cells are present. Okay, let me show you this entire figure. Now let's discuss the sixth point. Now the peculiarity of hair cell. Okay, see, on the top surface of the hair cell, stereo cilia are present. So here in this figure, you can see on the top surface they are showing the stereo cilia. And what are this stereo cilia? So stereo cilia, we know now, stereo cilia are actually microvilli, and the stereo cilia are having graduate height. Okay, they are having good enough height they are having, the stereo cilia. Then along with the stereo cilia, one kinocilium is also present on the surface of hair cell. And this kinocilium, what is this kinocilium? So kinocilium is actually a conventional cilium, and this cilium kinocilium extend beyond the longest stereocilium. So here these are all stereocilium, and the kinocilium is extending beyond this stereocilia. Okay, so this is the sixth point of our discussion. Now the seventh point. Now, in the seventh point, as we have studied the cochlea, so as in the cochlea, the stereocilia, they are connected by tiplings. Okay, so here you can see these are the stereocilia they are showing, and they are connected by the tipling. So we have already discussed about the tipling in our previous lecture. Okay, so stereocilia are connected by tipling. Let me show you this entire figure. See, here potassium channel of the, this is actually cochlear hair cell. Okay, but same type of tiplings are also present on the hair cell of the macula. Okay, and potassium channels, so they are also present in the hair cell of the macula. Okay, so this is the seventh point. Now we are moving forward. See, in this figure also, okay, this is the electron micrograph they are showing. So electron micrograph of the kinocilium and stereocilia of vestibular sensory hair cell. So this S means they are all stereocilia, and K means this one is the kinocilium, and this is the on right hand side. As you can see, figure B is showing the cross section of stereocilia and the kinocilium. Now, collectively, the stereocilia and kinocilium are called hair bundle. So together, stereocilia plus kinocilium, they are forming hair bundle. Okay, stereocilia and kinocilium collectively known as hair bundle. So in this figure, you can see hair bundle is shown. Okay. Now the ninth point we are discussing. See, scattered among the hair cell. So in between the hair cell, columnar cells are present, and these columnar cells are known as supporting cell. Now this supporting cell, they secrete thick gelatinous glycoprotein layer, which is known as otolytic membrane. So here in the figure, this purple color cell are the hair cell, and this pink color, light pink color cell, are the supporting cell. So this supporting cell, they are secreting gelatinous glycoprotein layer, and this gelatinous glycoprotein layer is known as otolytic membrane. Now otolytic membrane, where this membrane is present, so otolytic membrane rest on the hair cell. So on the surface of hair cell, this otolytic membrane is present. Okay, otolytic membrane. Now in this otolytic membrane, layer of dense calcium carbonate crystal is also present, and this dense calcium carbonate crystal are known as otoliths. Now otoliths, what are otoliths? Oto means ear, and lids means stone. So otoliths are actually ear stones, and this ear stone are present in otolytic membrane, and this otolith, they extend over the entire surface of the otolytic membrane. So here you can see this one is the otolytic membrane, and these are all you can see, these are all otoliths. So when we zoom, the otoliths look like this. Okay, so let me show you this entire figure. This is our theory point, and this is the figure. Okay. One more figure, let me show you. See, in this figure also, okay. See, otolytic membrane and otoliths. See, hair bundle they are showing, hair cell they are showing, okay, supporting cell they are showing. Now the macula of utricle and saccule are perpendicular to one another. okay, they are having an angle of 90 degree, okay, macula of utricle and sacule are perpendicular to each other. See, when the head is in an upright position, see, over here in this small box, one girl is shown and the head of girl is in a upright position. So when our head is in upright position, that time the macula of utricle is oriented horizontally. So for example, in this figure, see, over here it is written macula in upright head position. So you can see that the macula is horizontal when our head is in an upright position. Okay, and the macula of the sacule is oriented vertically. Okay, when our head is in a upright position. Now, because of this orientation, the utricle and sacule have different function role. They are having different function, the utricle and sacule. Now, the utricle is going to respond during linear acceleration or deceleration that occurs in a horizontal direction. For example, when you are driving your car and you are speeding your car, that time there is a linear acceleration, and when you reach to your destination, when you reach close to your destination, that time you are slowing your car. So now that is linear deceleration. Okay, so that time when you are traveling in your car, that time the utricle is responding. Okay, now utricle also respond when the head tilt forward or backward. Okay, for example, in this figure, see, over here the head is tilted, okay, downward, and here head tilted upward. So in this situation also utricle is going to respond. Okay, utricle is activated, macula is activated. Now in case of sacule, so when the sacule respond, see, sacule respond to linear acceleration or deceleration that occurs in a vertical direction, linear acceleration or deceleration, that time sacule respond. For example, when your body is moving up or down in an elevator, okay, so that time sacule respond. Okay, so this is the 10th point of our discussion. Now in this figure, see, okay, see, macula of saculi and macula utriculi, they are showing. Okay, so see, this boy is a medical entrance aspirant. He is having a age of 25 year old, you know, 25 year old boy can give medical entrance, and he is reading biology theory. He is reading, okay, not the MCQ, he is reading the theory. So now when the theory part he is reading, what happens? See, here he tried to in this figure, he is trying to remember the theory points. So that time his head is upright, okay. So see, macula horizontal, and when the boy is looking, when the boy is reading from the notes, that time the head tilted downward. So now the macula, you see the position of the macula, okay. So macula also tilted. Okay, so this is here. Now in this position also, see the head upright. Now the head tilt, okay, direction of tilt. So you see the position of macula, okay. You see the position of when the head is upright, that time you see the position of otolithic membrane, kinocilium, hair cell, okay. Then this is the time when the head is tilted, okay. So you see the position of otolithic membrane, kinocilium, hair cell. Now once again here head is upright, and here head is tilted in other direction, okay. So you see the arrangement of otolithic membrane, kinocilium, hair cell, everything. So this this figure will give you the idea, okay, regarding the position of macula and receptor organ. One more figure I would like to show you in this figure, okay. See on the left hand side, macula of utricle, macula of saccule. So here see all the names, okay, otolith membrane, otolith, they are showing kinocilium, stereocilia, hair cell, supporting cell, vestibular nerve. See girl's head in upright position. Now girl's head tilted forward, okay, and in this position, in this figure, girl's head tilted backward, okay. So what happens, okay, so all the changes are written over here, okay. Okay, now we are moving forward. Now point number 11 we are discussing. See, because the otolithic membrane sits on top of the macula, okay, where the otolithic membrane is present, so on the top of the macula it is present. So when you tilt your head forward, for example when you are saying yes, that time what happened, the otolithic membrane along with the otolith is pulled by gravity. So otolithic membrane slides downhill over the hair cell, okay, in the direction of the tilt, and bending the hair bundle. So when we tilt our head forward, when we are saying yes, that time what happened, otolith membrane is sliding downhill over the hair cell, okay, and due to this the hair bundle are bending. Now this is one case, okay. Now in case if you are sitting upright in a car and you suddenly brake your car, okay, so sudden jerk forward the otolithic membrane lags behind the head movement due to the inertia. So once again, you are sitting upright in a car that suddenly jerk forward, the otolithic membrane is lagging behind the head movement, okay. So otolithic membrane cannot follow the movement of your head, so otolithic membrane is remaining behind due to the inertia, okay. Now in this situation the hair bundle is going, okay, to pull. So this is pulling the hair bundle, and now the hair bundle is going to bend in another direction, opposite direction. So in this case, bending of the hair bundle, see, now so we are having two situation, bending forward, bending backward. So when we bend forward, for example, when we are saying yes, that time what happened, bending a hair bundle in one direction stretches the tiplings, and as the tipling are stretched, so the cation channels are open. So now the cation channels are open, so the hair cell or the receptor are depolarized, okay. So now there is a production of depolarizing receptor potential, and when we bend our head in opposite direction, for example, when we are braking our car, okay, and our head moves in opposite direction, okay, that time what happened, the channels are closed, potassium channels are closed, and the hair cells are hyper polarized, okay. The same points are also mentioned over here, okay. See, for example, first here, this is figure A, and you can see the stereocilia. So now we are discussing the mechanism for neurotransmitter release in the hair cell of the auditory system. Figure A, this figure is showing scanning electron micrograph of a bundle of outer hair cell stereocilia at the top of single hair cell. See, bending stereocilia in one direction, we are remembering this point, bending stereocilia in one direction depolarize the cell and stimulate the neurotransmitter release, and bending in opposite direction repolarize the cell and stop the release of neurotransmitter. So here in this case, for example, okay, in this case what is happening, when we are bending our head, that time what happened, see, tipling stretch, potassium channel are open, potassium ion are entering into stereocilia. So now hair cell is depolarized, and you can see calcium channels are also open, calcium entering inside. So synaptic vesicle, they are exocytosis, they are bursting, neurotransmitter are released, and now there is a generation of nerve impulse or the nerve signal in the efferent neurons. Efferent neurons are also known as primary sensory neurons, yeah. And when we bend our head in opposite direction, that time what happened, tipling slack, okay, calcium channels are closed, potassium channels are closed, no transmitter, neurotransmitter is not released, okay. So nerve signal is not generated, it is not propagating in the afferent neuron. So this is the point number 11. Now in this figure also, see, first, see, discharge rate of vestibular nerves, they are showing, resting activity, stimulation. So you see the position of stereocilia during depolarization and hyperpolarization inhibition, that time the stereocilia bending opposite direction. Now in this case the boy is standing tall, head is upright, okay. So you see the position of macula, okay. So macula is horizontal and here now the boy is going for a jogging and he is wearing the shoes, okay. So now what is happening, see, macula is tilted, okay. Macula is not in a horizontal direction. So effect of head position on otolith organ of the utricle, a upright position, okay, this is the upright position and the macula. So what happened, see, in upright position hair cells are not bent, and in B figure when the boy is wearing the shoes, that time due to gravity bends the hair cell when the head is tilting forward, okay. This informs the brain about the position of the head in space. The same response occur during the linear deceleration of the head as occur when applying the brakes of a car, okay. Sudden brake when you apply, so that time also the head is going tilting, okay. So one more figure I would like to show you. See, in this case, first, this is the normal condition, okay, and due to the sudden jerk, the girl head tilted upward, okay. When you apply a brake in a moving car, so due to that the girl's head is tilted upward. Now what happened, stereocilia bend toward the kinocilium, hair cell depolarize, increasing neurotransmitter release. So now increase nerve signal frequency along vestibular branch of cranial nerve 8, excitation. Now after that the girl's head is going to tilt downward, so that time stereocilia bent away from kinocilium, hair cell hyperpolarize inhibiting the release of the neurotransmitter. So now decrease nerve signal frequency along vestibular branch of cranial nerve 8, so this time inhibition. Now we are discussing the final point of this lecture, okay. So So when the hair cell depolarize and hyperpolarize, when the hair cell depolarize, they release neurotransmitter. And when the hair cell hyperpolarize or repolarize, so when this cell depolarize, they are releasing neurotransmitter at faster rate, okay? And when the hair cell hyperpolarize, that time they are releasing neurotransmitter at a slower rate, okay? Now, now the hair cell synapse with two type of cells. One type of cell is known as first order sensory neuron. And these are the neurons, okay? The fibers of first order secondary neuron, they form the vestibular branch of vestibulocochlear nerve. Now, this neuron fire nerve impulses at a slow or rapid pace depending on the amount of neurotransmitter release. So when we tilt our head in forward direction, when we are saying yes, that time what happened? The hair cells are going to depolarize and we are going to release more neurotransmitter, okay? So now the nerve impulse are generated and they are going to propagate by the vestibular branch of vestibulocochlear nerve. Now efferent neurons are also synapsing with the first order sensory neuron plus the hair cell. So efferent neuron synapse with first order sensory neuron and with the hair cell. Now what are the function of this efferent neuron? So efferent neuron, they regulate the sensitivity of the hair cell and the sensory neuron. So in this figure, as you can see over here, this is the hair cell, and with the hair cell, with the yellow color, they are showing the efferent nerve. So we know efferent nerve is having efferent neuron, and these efferent neuron are actually first order sensory neuron. So this first order sensory neuron, they are synapsing with the hair cell. Then the green color cells are the efferent neuron of the nerve. So green color efferent nerve, efferent neurons, they are synapsing. As you can see here, they are synapsing with the efferent neuron, and here they are synapsing with the hair cell. So let me show you this figure. Now see, in this case, first girl's head is in upright position. So in this position, see steady stream of action potential in vestibular nerve. Okay, now when the girl head is tilted forward, so now what happened? Hair bends toward, okay, stereocilia. The hairs bend toward kinocilium, hair cell depolarize, okay, more neurotransmitter is going to release, nerve fiber or the efferent neurons or the first order sensory neuron are going to excited. Now in this efferent neuron, action potential now propagate, and now action potential or the nerve signal enter into the vestibular nerve. Now the girl's head tilted backward. So now what happened? Hairs bend away from kinocilium. Hair cell repolarize or hyperpolarize. Now in this case, nerve fiber inhibited. So hair cell are not going to, or they are going very less amount of neurotransmitter is going to release. So there is very very low action potential are generated in vestibular nerve. Okay. See here in this case, here they are showing when our head is tilted forward, okay. So that time tapering stretch, potassium channel open, calcium channel open, neuro secretory vesicle exocytosis, neurotransmitter release. Now the action potential generated propagate into afferent neuron. Now when we tilt our head back, that time tapering slack, potassium channel close, calcium channel close, no release of neurotransmitter, no generation of nerve impulse. Okay. So with this, all the theory point we have discussed. Once again, I would like to show you that figure. Coming back to that figure. 1 minute. So in this figure you see, okay. See, head tilt, okay. So now what happened? See, stereocilia bend toward the kinocilium, the hair cell depolarize and release more glutamate neurotransmitter. And here when the head tilt in opposite direction, that time what happened? Stereocilia bend away from the kinocilium, the hair cell hyperpolarize and release less neurotransmitter, release less glutamate. Okay, so here you can see hair cell they are showing and vestibular nerve. So in the vestibular nerve there are two type of neuron, afferent neuron will send the nerve impulse in the brain center, and from the brain center the nerve impulse reaches to the efferent neuron, they control the activity of hair cell and afferent sensory neuron. So with this we have completed this discussion on equilibrium. I hope you have enjoyed this lecture, and I also hope that this presentation lecture will be helpful in your exam preparation and also in your studies. My name is Manish Koshti, sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye-bye. Namaste.